Have you ever wondered what's inside a Catholic church? Well, why don't you join us today and we'll try and explain some things for you.
That's right, Father Charlie. I think every Catholic and even non-Catholics have been inside a church and said, what's that or what's that all about?
You're right. So let's go in and find out.
Sounds good. In this episode, we're going to discover two more sacred spaces within the Catholic Church, the Reconciliation Chapel, or Room, and the Blessed Sacrament Chapel. Father Charlie, good to see you again.
Mark, good to see you.
We are standing before probably one of the most sacred spaces within a Catholic Church.
Yes, indeed.
The place where the tabernacle sits.
Yes.
Explain.
Well, in the tabernacle is the Blessed Sacrament. Now, the Blessed Sacrament has been consecrated during Mass, during the Christ's Eucharistic sacrifice. But after the Mass is over, the real presence of Christ remains in the host, remains in the Blessed Sacrament. So it's put into the tabernacle for several different reasons. In the ancient church, the principal reason was to have it to take to the sick and the homebound, people that could not attend Mass. But as time went by, it developed into a devotional presence, and people would come to be in front of the Blessed Sacrament to pray, to feel close to Christ, to experience His presence, His power, and His love. Now, when a Catholic comes into the church, walks into the church, the first thing the Catholic is going to look for is the sanctuary lamp. And the sanctuary lamp tells them two things. Tells them that, one, where the tabernacle is located, but more importantly, the sanctuary lamp that's lit, the candle is burning, indicates that Christ is present, truly and really present, in His precious body and blood in the Blessed Sacrament.
So the sanctuary lamp really is like a beacon or a lighthouse for Catholics, signifying that the presence of the Lord is with them.
Yes, and it has an ancient origin. The Jewish people had a sanctuary lamp or a similar lamp, candle, burning in front of the manna bread that they had received from the hands of the Lord. So Christians picked up on the symbol, but of course it has a much deeper symbol richness to it.
And the Blessed Sacrament Chapel is a place when the faithful come to church on days other than Sunday.
Indeed.
Is a place where they can find solitude with Christ.
Indeed.
Within the church.
Indeed, indeed. They come and they pray the rosary. They come and pray their special prayers, but mostly they come with their hearts open to receive, you know, the love of Christ, who's constantly present to us, particularly in the Blessed Sacrament.
Father Charlie, we are now in a very small, intimate space within a Catholic church, and that's the Reconciliation Room or Chapel.
Yes, it's also a place of peace, quiet. It should be comfortable. A place where people can unburden themselves and find freedom from guilt and freedom from whatever heaviness is on their heart.
Unburdened and peace are words that you used, and that's something that a lot of people need to find in their lives today.
That's right, that's right. Instead of the psychiatrist's office, they should be here.
Let's explore.
All right.
So, Father Charlie, this would be the situation if I were going to receive the sacrament of reconciliation face to face.
Absolutely.
Or I could choose anonymity by being on the other side of the wall.
That's correct.
As far as what you're wearing, I notice you're wearing a stole.
Yes, whenever a priest is functioning precisely as a priest, he wears the stole. Whenever he celebrates the sacraments, particularly, he wears the stole. And this, of course, is the great sacrament of Christ's presence to us to forgive us. We confess not to the priest, but we confess to God. Particularly, we confess to the Lord Jesus, who comes to give us freedom.
So that old saying, like, what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, really can apply to the confessional or the reconciliation chapel, because there is a sacramental privacy respected to this.
And the priest can't reveal it even by court order. In fact, some priests have been imprisoned because they refused to divulge what the penitent confessed.
Some folks probably shudder at the thought of going to confession because they feel burdened by it. But really, the reconciliation room in today's Catholic Church is really a peaceful, comfortable place, as you alluded to earlier.
It's a sanctuary of entering into Christ's sacred heart.
So very peace, liberating, mercy, grace, those all describe the gift of this sacrament.
Absolution is the reason why you come to receive the sacrament. God the Father of mercies, through the death and resurrection of his Son, has reconciled the world to himself and sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. To the ministry of the Church, may God grant you pardon, may he grant you peace. And I, by his authority, absolve you from each and every sin of your whole life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Go in peace.
In our next episode of What's Inside a Catholic Church, what will we be taking a look at, Father Charlie?
We'll be looking at the statues, the Stations of the Cross, stained glass windows, and all of those images of the household of faith, the members of our family of faith.
So please join us in our next episode of What's Inside a Catholic Church.